doesn't take a mathematician to add a simple sum. Either you are simply beautiful, or I am simply dumb, 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 dumb. Dumb, dumb, dumb. Dumb, dumb, dumb. It doesn't take Robert the Bruce to see the web you spun. Either you are simply beautiful, or I am simply dumb, 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 dumb. Dumb, dumb, dumb. Dumb, dumb, dumb. Doesn't take a Labrador to show a blind man's sign. Either you are simply beautiful, or I am simply dumb, 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 dumb. Dumb, dumb, dumb. Dumb, dumb, dumb. Stars, Jupiter, Neptune, and Mars. All these things I clearly see. It don't take a telescope for you to love me. For you to love me. So, so dumb, dumb, dumb. So, so simply dumb. So dumb, dumb, dumb.
Tabloid press would have you believe that the beautiful South are a band of hard-drinking, fun-loving semi-criminals, much given to laddishness and general outlandish behaviour. Now, this probably isn't that far from the truth. However, they also contain the most successful songwriting partnership since the Beatles' Lennon and McCartney. They're the fastest-selling band in pop history. They've had 20 hit singles. They've had 7 hit albums, 2 of which have made number one. And in England, 1 in 7 homes owns a copy of their greatest hits compilation, Carry On Up the Charts. The band's songwriters are Paul Heaton and David Rotheray, who, legend has it, write all the band's songs during a yearly 2-week package holiday to Gran Canaria. Heaton's previous partner was Norman Cook, who currently trades under the name Fatboy Slim. Together, they were in the House Martins, a band Heaton broke up in 1989.
I don't think there's anybody could say that the House Martins should have gone on longer. Any work offered to us, we took it, really. So we went on every kids' television show. We did every single gig we got offered, practically. We did sort of long, heavy, scheduled tours. And I just thought the bubble would burst, and I sort of wanted to be the one to pop it rather than people to go off us. It was much more intense. There being just four of us as well, and we were just travelling around in a little van. I'd rather sort of like stop it before we fell out. I mean, we sort of went straight to the top, and I could see it sort of going to peter out, and people would become bored of us. I don't think we would have made a really good third album. We had a sort of basically lads following it. So to introduce a female singer, probably people would have started accusing of us, the laddish element would have said we were getting softer. I don't know, it was just a good career move. The House Martins weren't really hand-picked, it was sort of, it just happened, and we sort of had to get a bassist and a drummer very quickly. Whilst with Beautiful South, I sort of like took a year off while I was writing new lyrics, and, well, not took a year off, but I had a year to think about it. So they were more hand-picked, the Beautiful South. I just felt as though I wanted to write songs for female singers as well as male singers. I thought it'd be quite interesting me writing about a woman's attitude towards a relationship. A bit like Agatha Christie. Oh. She was a bloke. I think originally I got the ideas from Teardrops by Womack and Womack, which I was totally obsessed with for about 4 months. I just really liked everything about our band, about the fact that he'd written the songs and she was sort of like singing them, and it seemed to hit the nail right on the head how she felt, sort of thing.
In a music world where all too often band members are auditioned and songwriting teams carefully assembled, it's refreshing to find that a partnership which now rivals the Beatles came together pretty much on the street where they lived. Heaton approached old friend and rival band member David Rotheray.
Well, he was sort of like one of the few local musicians who hadn't expressed any sort of jealousy. I think a lot of the other local musicians thought we'd got too big for our boots, or said, I could have wrote that song anyway. You're a lot of, I've been doing this for years. Why should you become famous? And David always sort of like through gritted teeth said, I really like the new song. It's done really well, hasn't it? Congratulations. So I asked him to form a band with us. I knew he wrote songs anyway because he was the sort of chief songwriter in the Velvetones. But like the black bird on the wire, I will not take prey on you. You wouldn't want me to, for I'm too soft for such a thing. I'm like the black bird on the wire, I just watch you by. The tears on you I'd cry fall unnoticed down below. Front to make you happy, back to make you weep, lips to keep you kissing. Whilst everyone's asleep, tears to break a backbone, laughs to win a war. And people come and ask me what I love you for. Like the blackbird on the wire.
When Brianna Corrigan left the Beautiful South in 1993, citing musical differences and unacceptable laddishness, it created an opportunity for Jacqui Abbott to join the band in circumstances not far removed from those of a fairy tale.
It was Andy Cave who invited us to the party.
You
also
got
like a house party type thing. It was sort of sat on the lawn, and He was singing first. I wouldn't have sang otherwise, but he was singing first. That's not a lie. You were singing first.
Yeah, I know.
Was it Happy Hour?
He was singing different songs. He was telling us what kind of music he liked, and he was just singing different songs, you know. And one of my a friend who I went with, who came with me, she was saying, you should sing in front of him, you know, you've got a good voice. And I did. And he said to me, he said, it'd be nice if you did something with the band in the future. And I was like, right. And I just laughed at him, you know, and when we left the party, it was like, it must have been about a year and a half afterwards, wasn't it?
2 years.
2 years afterwards. The lad we knew in St. Andy Caber, we knew in St. Helens, he told him to go and find, try and find me where I worked or where, you know, try and find out where I lived or where I worked or anything.
He looked for about 2 weeks.
I know. But he didn't even, he couldn't remember if he'd found the right one.
Yeah.
Actually, when he didn't even know I was the right person then, so.
I just said, do you remember that woman who was, well, you were only 17 at the time. Do you remember that woman who sat on the grass singing at your party? And he'd been really... Anyway, so he had to look round everywhere for you, and he found her doing what?
Throwing Mara's papers on a shelf.
Working in a...
Fruit and veg shop.
Fruit and veg shop.
Paul and Dave came across and meet me in St. Helens, and they said, would you come down to London and sort of do an audition? It was sort of an audition, wasn't it? It was just like sat with... I was sat with Paul and Dave and John Kelly, the producer, and I sang Prettiest Eyes Dinner, and... I sang that song, and then it just went on, and I did the full album, but I didn't do it as a member of the band, you know. It was just sort of like session singer, really. And then it came like 2 weeks before the Christmas of 94, I got a phone call from Bambi, who was the manager at the time, and he said, like, we've had a meeting and we'd like you to join the band, so.
You sounded a bit nervous at first, but I mean, yeah. Jacqui had never been in a studio before or ever been in a band at all. I think You still sound, you know, like if you listen to everybody's talking, there's like a bit of a quaver to Jacqui's voice, as though, you know, like it's a debut album sort of thing. But considering she'd never been in the studio, it's a pretty terrifying atmosphere if you're just sort of told you don't stack shelves anymore, this is what you do. It was too early to just say, right, you're joining the band, so we just sort of gave her own time to make the decision.
Pretty ladies in my ears and in my eyes. Back to where you want.
The Beatles Night, next Monday on VH1.
Although it might appear to be simply the stuff of legend, Heaton and Rotheray really do write all the songs together on their annual 2-week package trip to Grand Canaria. Those 2 weeks, however, only represent the culmination of a much longer writing process.
We have two ways of writing songs. One is, I'll come into the room with a set of lyrics and already an idea for the tune. Quite often it's totally concrete. I've got the absolute tune, but I've only got it in my head because I can't write music or write English language at all. The other one's Czechoslovakian, which I speak fluently and write fluently. Now, the other way is that I sometimes bring a set of lyrics and I've just got a rhythm, you know, like, da-da-da-da-da-da-da. That was Keep It All In. and Dave will have a set of chords and he'll sort of, I'll try and improvise the lyric into his chords. So Dave's much more involved in that way. I think just working with Dave playing the guitar in front of me, it sort of throws up quite a bit of random tunes in my head sort of thing, so it tends to be a bit more improvised and quite often you'll get a good tune out of it. The other way, I'll just sing it to him and he works it out. But the actual songwriting takes place on a 2-week package holiday to Gran Canaria. We work Monday to Saturday, Sunday's day off, write a song each day, that's 12 songs. And then quite often come back. And the third way we might write a song is if we're waiting for the tape to rewind in the studio, sometimes we'll just start playing around. I think they call it a jam. And I'll start singing on top of it. That's probably the rarest way we write songs. They usually get relegated to B-sides. Apart from Dom, which was a bit like that, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Doesn't take a mathematician to add a simple sum. Either you are simply beautiful, or I am simply dumb, 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 dumb. Dumb, dumb, dumb. Dumb, dumb, dumb. It doesn't take Robert the Bruce to see the web you've spun. Either you are simply beautiful, or I am simply dumb, 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 dumb. Dumb, dumb, dumb. Dumb, dumb, dumb. It doesn't take a Labrador to show a blind man's sign. Either you are simply beautiful, I am simply dumb, dumb.
Released in 1994 of the compilation hits album, Carrying Up the Charts was an industry phenomenon. It quickly reached number one, and to date has sold 3 million units. It changed the band's lives both financially and artistically. However, the wisdom of what in retrospect was a masterstroke didn't seem that clear to the band at the time.
It was a bit embarrassing because we'd said to the record company, it's a really bad idea.
Yeah.
So we're sort of denying it for at least 2 or 3 months.
Yeah.
Number one, who wants a number one?
Yeah, it was sort of, well, I'm not going to say unexpected, but I suppose when you consider it, I mean, we had had quite a lot of hit singles, so if you put them all together, it's bound to sell, but I don't think we was really, you know, expecting it at all.
I think we realised it was going to sell quite well when we saw the advert, because the advert seemed to sort of like cram like 7 or 8 songs in that I think everybody knew. And I mean, when you hear them sort of back to back over 30 seconds, it's quite obvious that we'd had a lot of sort of partial hits, mini hits sort of thing.
Yeah, the songs work quite well as in 3 or 4 second blasts as well. They're just catchy that way. I mean, some people's songs are landscapes, aren't they? So they just sound terrible on adverts, you know. Except if there's a car in front of it.
A fast one.
Yeah.
Which brakes really quickly.
Yeah.
And dust.
It was good for, like, songwriting, because it gave us sort of a year or so to sort of, like, think of new ideas, and it gave us sort of a bit of a fresh outlook. I mean, I know blue is the colour, isn't it? Experimental. I don't think we've ever been that, but it enabled us to play around a little bit more than perhaps we would have done.
I think, I mean, Paul wears his hat on his sleeve when it comes to writing lyrics, you know. Basically, what you see is what he's feeling at the time, I think. Is that right?
I think so, yeah.
There you go, you see.
Yeah.
This weekend from Los Angeles, one of music's biggest events, My VH1 Music Awards. But don't just watch, get involved. You can vote for the best UK acts on our website at www.vh1.co.uk. No recounts, no lawyers, it's up to you. Then watch the main event on My VH1 Music Awards weekend, this weekend.
I saw mommy kissing underneath the mistletoe last night. Oh, what a laugh it would have been if Daddy had only seen mommy kissing Santa Claus last night.
I was painted by Leonardo da Vinci. You'd know that smile came from him kissing my hair.
Just take a stroke of genius from me. All a masterpiece needs is the kind of dandruff-free hair I get from the new Head & Shoulders.
When life imitates art, there's no room for dandruff. New Head & Shoulders, a source of dandruff-free kissable hair.
Thank you. full of the greatest love songs of all time. This superb collection includes a bonus CD of classic love songs, only available with this special television offer. ...128 timeless love classics. 8 CDs plus the bonus disc. Just call this number now. Don't you know, things can change, things will go your way. If you hold on for one more day, when I wonder... 8 CDs packed full of your favourite love songs. Only $29.99 plus post and packing. These are the greatest love songs, and they're available to you by calling the number on your screen now. Don't miss out on this incredible offer. Call now.
Is it bad to get what you want? Life isn't black and white. It's gold. J'adore. A fragrance from Christian Dior.
Want to be 007?
Do you have the time?
Certainly.
Oh! Need more practice?
Now check out.
Lambrini girls just want to have fun.
Thanks, Bobby. Merry Christmas.
Because we can rely on Amazon.co.uk to deliver our Christmas presents, we can sit back and take it nice and easy. Snowy white
Christmas. Make yourself comfy, my wee laddie.
Amazon.co.uk, a real company in a virtual world.
I spread the rich clover
on muffins and toast.
With crumpets and jams, how we like it most.
I like it on soldiers.
Dip in my egg.
It's great with their sarnies, so pass it here, Meg.
And it's rainbow potatoes.
With clover and cheese.
Churned with fresh dairy ingredients.
So pass it back, please.
Clover. Loved all over.
If you feel as though you're extraordinary, you're always running a little bit of a battle with the ordinary, aren't you? It's always a bit of a cat and mouse to it. And you're always trying to sort of reaffirm your own idiosyncrasies to just show you're a little bit different to everybody else. And I probably have got a more of a fear of the normal than the paranormal. I felt a bit disappointed about the lyrics in Quench, lyrically. I don't think they were bad, but I didn't think they showed any sort of marked improvement from Blues of Colour. I thought with, like, Liar's Bar, Alone and Blackbird, I sort of showed a bit of personality that hadn't existed in my lyrics before, so I was a bit disappointed. So I'm sort of writing the new lyrics at the moment, hoping that I'll be able to sift through them a bit better than I did last time. I think they're all right, but I don't think they're quite so stirring emotionally on Quench. But motivation-wise, I'm just trying to remember what you've done, really, and trying to write it down accurately. And just trying to hit the nail on the head. I hit the nail on the head with Quench, but I was using an incredibly large hammer. That's how I describe it. Are that big.
Think of you with pipe and slippers. Think of her in bed, laying there just watching telly. Think of me instead. I'll never grow so old and flabby. That could never be. Don't marry her, have me. And your love light shines like copper, but your work shoes are glistening. She's a PhD and I told you so. You've been idling and I'm not listening. She'll grab your Sandra books and slowly paint her knee. Don't marry her, have me. And the Sunday sun shines down on Sandra.
on in bed. Those blackbirds look like knitting needles trying to beg your head. Those birds will beg you so hard. Throw away the key. Don't marry her, have me. The kitchen's always tidy. And the bathroom's always clean. Roam around just hiding things you've ever burst in rose tea. Socks smell of angels, July smells of green. Don't marry her, have me.
I've got sort of better at making videos because they used to be real. I mean, there's so much waiting around. The more people there, the more members of the band there are there, the better fun it is. But in general, they're pretty tedious, really. Just because they've been better since we've worked with the same directors. Because a lot of the directors in the past have just sort of like said, right, we need you now. And you've just sat around or stood around for like an hour and a half. But I think Liam and Grant, who we work with now, tend to realise that if they ask us to be there, we will be there, as long as it, you know, the camera's ready to roll. Whilst the other video directors would have just sort of hidden from, you know, ran to the pub or hidden bushes, and just anything to not get pushed around by a bunch of studious London idiots.
Despite the obvious intelligence in their lyrics and an impressive recording output of 7 albums in 10 years, the Beautiful South are still most likely to be characterised in the press by their drunken exploits. This is an image which songs like Old Red Eyes is back and The Liar's Bar do little to counter.
I don't think we're too bad. I think we're pretty steady. I think people associate carousing, that's my new word, that, with, like, really, really outlandish behaviour. And like throwing televisions out windows, and we haven't really got the energy to bend down and unplug the television set.
Phil, could you get us this plug for us?
Plus there's teletext now. Major breakthrough for us rock and rollers. You don't want to throw it out. You don't want to throw it out the window, do you, when you can
no.
Read page 561, Showbiz Goss. Sorry, 566.
I think yeah. We're all right. We do have our, like, an odd day when
we've had a really good night the night before, like the gig and sort of after show, if you call it, and we then go on into the next day and start drinking a bit early. There was one show at Cambridge which, where I was on stage, and it really, even thinking about it now, I just think I let the people who paid money down. I certainly wouldn't have set out to get drunk before I went on stage, anyway. so I'm not looking at you. Yeah, it's pretty embarrassing, you know, when people are saying, you know, you were really on stage last night. It's only really happened probably the once. There's been a couple of times when I've gone on stage and not realised I'd had as much to drink as I had, but you can usually get around that, hopefully. I think as long as we've got sort of tours ahead of us, as long as we've got tours to look forward to and recording to look forward to, there's no point in sort of treating every tour as the last tour. I think that's when we'd go really mad, is if we said, right, this is our final tour. That would be very dangerous.
I'm
not going to do what I did with Alice Martin, just stop it. Because it seems as though everybody's having a reasonably good time sort of thing anyway. I have my ups and downs, obviously, being a trampoline artist.
I had to get that one.
I occasionally think, well, you know, you should call it a day, but, like, my general thought about the band and working with all the band and all the people around it is it's never been so good, sort of, every day I sort of really enjoy.
'Cause we love our love. Different sizes. I love her body, especially the lies. Time takes its toll, but not on the eyes. Promise me this, take me tonight. If it's extra large, well, I'm in charge. I can work this thing on time.
And if he's XXL, well, what the hell? Every penny don't fit the slot. The anorexic chicks, the model six, they don't hold no weight with me. Well, 8 or 9, well, that's just fine, but I like to hold something I can see. 'Cause we love our love in different sizes. I love her body, especially the lies. Time takes its toll, but not on the eyes. Promise me this, take me tonight.
This weekend from Los Angeles, one of music's biggest events, my VH1 Music Awards. But don't just watch, get involved. You can vote for the best UK acts on our website at www.vh1.co.uk. No recounts, no lawyers, it's up to you. Then watch the main event on my VH1 Music Awards weekend, this weekend.
Songs I write and sing. cheap, never cheap. I'll sing your songs till you're asleep. When you've gone upstairs, I'll creep and write it all. So many songs about you, I forget your name, I forget your name.
Jennifer, Allison, Philippa Sue, Deborah, Annabelle Sue,
I forget your name.
Jennifer, Allison, Philippa Sue, Deborah, Annabelle Sue,
I forget your name. Upon the tears you weep, so cry, love, and cry. Oh, Kathy, oh, Anderson, oh, Philippa, oh, Sue. You made me so much money, I wrote this song for you. I wrote this song for you.
Jennifer, Anderson, Philippa, Sue.
The song for you.
Jennifer, Allison, Philippa Sue,
for
Deborah, Annabelle Sue.
The song for you.
Jennifer, Allison,
for
Philippa Sue,
for
Deborah, Annabelle Sue.
Song for you.
Monday on VH1.
Tomo played the ball through and I lost me marker.
Right, come on.
Controlled it on me chest.
Oh.
Then I floated it into their half. I was down the wing like a ferret. Their keeper comes off his line, so I leapt like a salmon.
With no peak hours, one-to-one vouchers go on and on.
Did I mention the groin strain?
What should we get for Dad, then?
Oh, don't worry about me. I don't want anything.
Yeah.
You didn't get me anything.
Talk it.
With three for the price of two on all our boxes of Christmas cards, and 3 for 2 on all packs of baubles. You may forget what you went in for.
But Murray Walker. And here is Murray Walker.
worth it this Christmas.
Benylin can help stop a persistent cough, whether you want it to or not.
Cough, please.
Umbrella. With this free £5 voucher, when you spend over £50, you may forget what you went in for. Offer extended, but must end on the 4th of December.
Oh, you're in the... umbrella. Sorry.
Woolworths. Well worth it this Christmas.
If I was painted by Leonardo da Vinci, you'd know that smile came from him kissing my hair.
Just take a stroke of genius from me. All a masterpiece needs is the kind of dandruff-free hair I get from the new Head & Shoulders.
When life imitates art, there's no room for dandruff. New Head & Shoulders, a source of dandruff-free kissable hair.
Hey, don't crease me.
What's the problem?
If only it was less creased.
I can wear mine straight from the line.
I'll stay put, so they won't see the creases.
Creases? What creases?
New Downy Fabric Enhancer has a clear complex. Unlike softeners which leave a coating on fibres, New Downy penetrates and smooths fibres from within for less creases. Not just after the wash, but all the time you wear them. Downy. My clothes. Only better.
Come on, we've got to get some wrapping paper.
With three for the price of two on all Chad Valley toys and games, you may forget what you went in for. Offer must end on the 11th of December.
Wrapping paper.
Woolworths.
Come on.
Well worth it this Christmas.
This weekend from Los Angeles, one of music's biggest events, My VH1 Music Awards. But don't just watch, get involved. Cool, you can vote for the best UK acts on our website at www.vh1.co.uk. No recounts, no lawyers, it's up to you. Then watch the main event on My VH1 Music Awards weekend, this weekend.
Telling me now.
per aver. Just like that murder in 73, just like that robbery in 62. Well, all these things that have happened to me, I kept them all in. I kept it all in. I kept it all in.
Think of you with pipe and slippers, think of her in bed, laying there just watching telly, think of me instead. I'll never grow so old and flabby, that could never be. Don't marry her, have me. And your love light shines like copper, but your work shoes are glistening. She's a PhD and I told you so, you've been idle and I'm not listening. Grab your Sandra Bullocks and slowly raise your knee. Don't marry her, have me. And the Sunday sun shines down on San Francisco Bay, and you realize you can't make it anyway. You have to wash the car, take the kiddies to the park. Don't marry her, have me. Those lovely breakfast brought in bed, those blackbirds look like knitting needles trying to peck your head. Those birds will peck you so hard, throw away the key. Don't marry her, have me. And the kitchen's always tidy, and the bathroom's always clean. Roam a ring just hiding things, you're the first in rose tea. And the socks smell of angels, July smell. Don't marry her, have me. And the Sunday sun shines down on San Francisco Bay, and you realize you can't make it anyway. You have to wash the car, take the kiddies to the park. Don't marry her, have me. Talking at me, I can't hear a word they're saying. Only the echoes of my mind. People stop and stare. I can't see their faces. Only the shadows of their eyes. I'm going where the sun keeps shining through the pouring rain. Going where the weather suits my clothes. Backing off of the northeast wind and sailing on summer breeze. Tripping over the ocean like a stone. Thank you.
She's a perfect 10, but she wears a 12. Baby, keep a little 2 for me. She could be sweet 16, busting out of the seams. It's still love in the first degree.
When he's at my game with a big fat A, you wanna see the smile on my face. And even at my door with a 4-4-4, there ain't no man can replace. Cause we love our love in different sizes. I love her body, especially the lies. Time takes its toll, but not on the eyes. Promise me this, take me tonight. If he's extra large, well, I'm in charge. I can work this thing on top. And if he's XXL, well, what the hell? Every penny don't fit the slot.
Ah, the anorexic chicks, the model sex, they don't hold no weight with me. Well, 8 or 9, well, that's just fine, but I like to hold something I can see. Cause we love our love different sizes. I love her body, especially the lies. Time takes its toll, but not on the eyes. Promise me this, take me tonight. I bought a watch to time your beauty, and I've had a little second hand.
I bought a calendar, and every month is taken up by the love of me.
Cause we love our love in different sizes. I love her body, especially the lies. Time takes its toll, but not on the eyes. Promise me this, take me tonight. Especially the lies. Time takes its toll, but not on the eyes. Promise me this, take me
inside my head, yeah. They're only
weekend from Los Angeles, one of music's biggest events, My VH1 Music Awards. But don't just watch, get involved.
I saw mommy kissing Santa underneath the mistletoe last night. Oh, what a laugh it would have been if Daddy had only seen mommy kissing Santa last night.
Thanks, Bobby. Merry Christmas.
Because we can rely on Amazon.co.uk to deliver our Christmas presents, we can sit back and take it nice and easy.
Right. Make yourself comfy, my wee laddie.
Amazon.co.uk, a real company in a virtual world.
Cold sore, don't hide away, treat it with Zevirax. Whether it's a blister or just a tingle, nothing can clear it faster. Zevirax, putting the smile back on your face.
With a softener, it still needs ironing.
I can wear mine straight from the line.
New Downy Fabric Enhancer.
My clothes only better.
Is Music of the Millennium 2. The greatest artists. The best music. With John Lennon, U2, The Rolling Stones, Bob Dylan, Aerosmith, Eric Clapton and Robbie Williams, plus Queen and David Bowie. Music of the Millennium 2. The album. Out now.
I spread the rich clover
on muffins and toast.
With crumpets and jams, how we like it most.
I like it on soldiers.
Dip in my egg.
It's great with their sarnies, so pass it here, Meg.
And it's baked potatoes. With clover and cheese.
Churned with fresh dairy ingredients.
Oh, we love the rich clover.
So pass it back, please.
Clover. Loved all over.
You're watching VH1, taking you inside music. VH1, your music, your moment.
Live at VH1.
Death.
you held and you treasured. Big kind you can't believe that you last. Little kiss that helped you when you needed. Little kiss, big kind. Little heart that has no exchange rate. Big kind that could join the island. Little heart is only greedy cause it's poor. Little heart, big kind. It's a tiny little heart that challenges the coin. But the coin has no north or no south. Big conscience, it will never ever leave you. Big coin, big mouth. Little heart, it ain't gold, it ain't silver. Little heart, it ain't wasted on me. Little heart, so much bigger than the coin. Little heart, big guarantee. Little heart, big guarantee. Little heart, little heart, little heart, little heart, little heart, little heart, little heart. Little heart that changes the coin, but the coin has no north or no south. Big coin says it will never ever leave you. Big coin, big mouth.
What was special about starting up this band was that most bands are thrown together accidentally. You know, you start off a band, you're a guitarist, and maybe you want to find a bass player, and you try and find a drummer, and you put an advert in a paper or something, and it's kind of an accidental mix of people. And sometimes that might be great, you might get a great chemistry. But with this band, it was actually sort of hand-picked as people who were good friends and shared the same ideas and would get on with each other. And that's why, probably, we've lasted so well and got on so well.
I suppose they all made me feel really welcome when I first joined, and they made me feel like it wasn't a big thing to be coming into. It wasn't like blown out of proportion. They just kept it like at quite a calm level, do you know what I mean, when I first joined. So I didn't really, there wasn't a big build up, and then it just all went downhill from there. It just stayed at a nice pace all the way through.
All my memories of this band really have just been what a good laugh it is. I've said before in interviews, we never argue at all. I think that's partly because of how many there is in the band, you know, with there being six of you, and you've always got somebody you can turn to have a go at or not have a go at.
One day I'm loaded, next day I'm broke. Spend all my money on whiskey and coke. Riding high till a rock hit the spoke. It was like windows shopping for blinds.
Spent all my money on a sunbed too. Spoke the best that a young girl can. Ended up with a blind drunk man. It's like windows shopping for blinds.
It's like the Heartbreak Hotel with a heartbreak but nowhere to stay. The doors are shut on us, the neon lights fade into grey. They say I drink too much, to me, well that's just profound. How do you know you can't swim until you have drowned? Well, there's always a drop in the bottle, lady. Always a sip of the wine. The glass doesn't seem quite so empty when windows shopping for blinds.
It's like a crashing feet.
That's
chestnuts who'd ever harvest a yield. Save your tears for your evening meal, from your window shopping for blinds. One day you're sober, next day you're not. One day remembered, next day forgot. Spend all my money on cocaine and pot. It's like window shopping for blinds.
Covered in bruises from head to toe. No one to speak to and nowhere to go. A map of nowhere, nowhere I know. It's like window shopping for blinds.
It's like the Heartbreak Hotel with a heartbreak but nowhere to stay. Doors are shut out, the neon lights faded to grey. You say I drink too much to me, well that's just profound. How do you know you can't swim until you have drowned? Well there's always a drop in the bottle, lady. Always a sip of the wine. The glass doesn't seem quite so empty when window shopping for blinds.
What if my husband's gone?
Well, tell me, what have you done? You cherish your vodka, you cherish your rum. Don't mind us, we're just licking our wounds in the sun.
Every 2 years we try and do an album. Me and Paul, the singer, go away for a couple of weeks to the Canary Islands and write songs. There's loads of different ways of writing songs. Everybody seems to do it a different way. The way we do it is Paul does all the lyrics first on his own, which is what Bernie Taupin and Elton John do as well. Bernie Taupin writes all the lyrics and sends them to him. That's what Paul does. He writes all the words completely, finishes the song before we start doing any music. And then we go away on holiday together with an acoustic guitar and just write the songs with a guitar. That's it.
Take a mathematician to add a simple sum. Either you are simply beautiful, or I am simply dumb, 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 dumb. It doesn't take Robert the Bruce to see the web you spun. Either you are simply beautiful, or I am simply dumb, 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 dumb. Dumb, dumb, dumb. Dumb, dumb, dumb. Doesn't take a Labrador to show a blind man's sign. Either you are simply beautiful, or I am simply dumb, 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 dumb. Dumb, dumb, dumb.
Los Angeles, one of music's biggest events, My VH1 Music Awards. But don't just watch, get involved. Cool, you can vote for the best UK acts on our website at www.vh1.co.uk. No recounts, no lawyers, it's up to you. Then watch the main event on My VH1 Music Awards weekend, this weekend.
Galaxy Silk Collection. Delicious indecision.
Do you have the time?
Certainly. It's the wrong one. Uh-oh. Oh. It's not.
Need more practice?
Thanks, Bobby. Merry Christmas.
Because we can rely on Amazon.co.uk to deliver our Christmas presents, we can sit back and take it nice and easy.
Right. Make yourself comfy, my wee laddie.
Amazon.co.uk, a real company in a virtual world.
Karen, honey,
when are you going to settle down?
Look at your sister. She's married with three lovely kids.
Look at me. I've had two perfect marriages.
Stevens, can you help me? It's about the Bisaki deal.
Yeah, about your motor, love. We had a bit of trouble with the clutch, and your carburetor's going to cost you a few bob. And your brakes are open evil up.
I'm just borrowing your dress. I promise I won't stain it again.
Karen, please. I know you need to spike, but please, can't we talk about it, darling?
Hello.
next Monday on VH1.
Since I've been in the beautiful South, I've always sort of written, sort of tried to like write arguments and things which went on, conversation, just telling a story and a lot of intense rivalry between the man and the woman, a lot of black humour.
With having a man and a woman singing, you can have interactive songs, you know, where the relationship's played out in words.
I think my songwriting would be pretty dull if I hadn't written for women.
A lot of people are less intelligent in their songs than they are in person. You know, you get these people who are sort of my age, not Jackie's because she's a lot younger, but people in their 30s, intelligent, educated people who write songs from the point of view of like a 15-year-old falling in love for the first time or something, you know. And we're probably, our songs are as intelligent as we are, which is probably quite unusual, if you see what I mean. Cynical and dark in their ordinary conversation, but most people don't put it into their songs, although they do in conversation. And I think we just are in song as we are in life, whereas most people are dumb it down a bit. What we mainly do is we try and imagine what our friends would think of the record, or, you know, sort of girlfriends or boyfriends whose taste in music we respect. And if we try and make an LP that we think they'll like, then maybe the other people like them in the country would like it as well.
If I walk like a fool, I've walked like that since school. Maybe it's the lure out the sea. Who knows the effect that whiskey could have had on me? It could have been the lure out the sea. Cause leather, it is strong as the weather, but leather can strangle any dream. And leather, it is strong as the weather, but leather to cut us from me. Says that's just the anarchist that kicks down modesty. Well, maybe it's the lure of the sea. Once I felt chained, but now I feel free. Maybe it's the lure of the sea. Well, those two had nothing on me. Could be I'm a sucker for the sea. Cause silver and as quick as the tongue, but silver took the mill so young. And metal ain't as strong as the pedal, but metal left the verse on the song. That's just the anarchist that kicks down modesty. Maybe it's the lure of the sea. Freedom's taken a liking to me. Well, maybe it's the lure of the sea. A look in my eye, cause my belt's broke free. Maybe it's the lure of the sea. The pirates of Penzance, they had nothing on me. Well, maybe it's the lure of the sea. Suicide's just the anarchist that kicks down modesty. Well, maybe it's the lure of the sea.
And we're still just ourselves, really. We don't have to... It's not like we do a big act or anything. And I think, in a way, that's what people like about us, you know, that we're just a bunch of people who are just... I mean, we're not... Obviously, we're not... If you're in a band and write songs, you're not ordinary. We're not completely average, because otherwise we wouldn't write songs that anybody liked. But the fact that we're not, you know, like, walking on stage with fireworks and, like, riding on a motorbike with 10-inch high heels or anything. Not that there isn't a place for that as well, but I think you've got to keep both ends of the candle burning, and we're keeping the musical end burning, just going on and playing some songs and then going home, really. And that's one of the best things about us, is that we just kept going down our own little path, ploughed our own furrow. And on the one hand, it meant we'd never be superstars, but on the other hand, it meant we'd always have a few people who liked us.
sitting in a bar alone, where no one knows your name. It's like laying in a graveyard wide awake. You're scared that if you cough or yawn, you might wake up the dead. So pretend to read a paper or drink instead. I'm a stand-up comedian, but I'd sit down if I could. The world just seems one folk like me to stand. And the punchlines seem to disappear like clouds across the sky. And the laughter could be real or could be kind. Rum by the kettle drum, whiskey by the jar, a liar's bar. Still alive. Don't bother with a cemetery, he'll be down and lies. I'm a traveling businessman, I just stopped him for one drink. You'll find that I'm not like the other man. The noses are red, what's mine is only pink. But they didn't choose a drink, the drink chose them. Kettle drum, whiskey by the jar, a liar's bar. And the gravedigger's smiling at his reflection in his spade. He's visiting the seediest of showers of graves. With the vocal cars of elephants and the characters of mice, they're singing whiskey, whiskey, so good they named it twice. And the sun, this is blue. Why don't pass buildings with lights on? If I said that, I'd eat out of light. Cause what looks like a Chinese restaurant may have Chinese food here inside. And some of my life I've been searching, the bars I've been in I forget. The light outside ever brighter, but a light on the inside not yet. Rum by the kettle drum, whiskey by the jar, the lights burn. Worldwide traveler, he's not like me or you, but he comes in mighty regular for one who's passing through. And that one came in his work clothes, he's missed his last bus home. He's missed a hell of a lot of buses for a man who wants to roam. You'll never get to roam, son. And son, this is brutal. If I look rough, I am rough. If I look sad, I am. If I look broke, I am broke. Just a broke down piece of man. Well, I've turned over enough leaves to fell an autumn. And if I had one final wish, I'd be a slave for a decade. If you could take me away from this, if you took me away from this, I'd be different, you'd see. Cause I didn't choose a drink chose me. Rum by the kettle drum, whiskey by the jar, a liar's bar. Chimney, I'm drinking like a fish, a liar's bar.
next Monday on VH1.
With the help of your digit here and Open, you can buy Open's number one games, DVDs, videos and books for only half price. So go on, treat someone special this Christmas. Open, how very useful.
Just press the button.
Cough, please. Cough, please. Cough, please. Cough, please. Cough, please. Will you please cough?
Benylin can help stop a persistent cough, whether you want it to or not.
Cough, please.
Thomson has created Senium with integrated DVD player. Changeable frame. 16x9 flat screen, giving you the big picture in your own home. Thompson, look, listen, and live.
From jamjar.com, and with their special deals you could save thousands and get it delivered to your door. What about my old car? Jamjar give you a trade-in price online and they'll take it away. Unbelievable! But that's not all. Pay just £9,995 for a Volkswagen Golf before the end of November and jet off to Paris with two free return tickets. Paris, eh? Well, where else would a model like me be seen?
That's what I call music.
So what are you going to cook?
Have a laugh. I'm always cooking. Why don't you cook for a change?
Oh, I hate cooking.
Here, look, it's just for it. Heads or tails?
Tails.
Can you get the door, sweet?
Happy Christmas.
I'm not having much luck so far.
Happy Christmas! Can I give you a hand?
Everything is perfect in here.
Oh!
You've got a present for me.
Turn me on the book.
Very nice. You've got the receipt.
You don't need to be a great cook to have a great Christmas with Sainsbury's.
Yeah, darling.
One, two, three, four.
Next Monday on VH1.
And the women tuck the hill like they're trying to prove it won't fall out. And all the men of gargoyles dip long in Irish staff. The whole place is pickled. The people are pickles for sure. And no one knows that they've done more here than they ever would do in a jar. This could be Rotterdam or anywhere. Liverpool or Rome. Cause Rotterdam is anywhere. Anywhere alone. And everyone is blonde and everyone is beautiful. And when blonde and beautiful are multiple, they become so dull and dutiful. And when faced with dull and dutiful, they fire at warning flares. Battle cocky personality with red underwear. This could be Rotterdam or anywhere, Liverpool or Rome. Cause Rotterdam is anywhere, anywhere alone. Anywhere alone. Is pickle. The people are pickles for sure, but no one knows that they've done more here than they ever would do in a jar. This could be Rotterdam or anywhere, Liverpool or Rome, cause Rotterdam is anywhere, anywhere alone. This could be Rotterdam or anywhere, Liverpool or Rome, cause Rotterdam is anywhere, anywhere. Anywhere alone, anywhere alone, anywhere alone, anywhere alone, alone, alone. Ooh, this could be Rotterdam.
People really took to me at first when I first started playing with them and went on tour. The crowds were just really good. They were just really, really good. I thought I'd get heckled and have things thrown at me, but I didn't.
Just a round of applause as soon as you walked in.
I did, yeah, and it was really good.
But stupid is one here, carry on regardless. The beat is hard, so there's no more blood, but carry on regardless.
It just got better and better, so it didn't. I thought it'd be really bad at first, but it just disappeared. As soon as I played to him for the first time, which is in Middlesbrough, wasn't it? Mm. It's quite a small crowd as well. It was only 650 people. So they were just really close up, and I was like, oh, petrified. But it was brilliant. It turned out really well.
Yeah, we like playing the smaller ones there. But there's so many of us in the band, you see, there's so many of us on stage, we lose loads of money when we play the small places. We often have more people on stage than in the audience.
It was a big thrill to be going away and staying in nice hotels and
trashing them.
Yeah, and stuff like that. But I didn't really feel like every day I wake up and think, oh God, what am I doing here, you know? Because I just really got used to it quite quickly, I suppose. And now, like, I just feel exactly the same. It's never changed, I suppose. My expectations weren't really high at first. I didn't think, oh, well, I'm going to be floating on cloud nine every day. So it's just stayed the same really all the way through. I still enjoy it really a lot, like, but I don't sit every day and think, oh, it's wonderful what I'm doing.
Never told before. before. I'm here to tell you tales whilst the fire plays for more. Closing up relationships and the open doors. The static of hostilities and the end of wars. Take care if you couldn't care to someone else's care. Cause someone took my care. They were there and then they were not there. We should have a baby. Quite so sad. One that makes me feel like Paul the same, not Jack the Lad. A baby that'll make me feel so very glad. I've had a life of booze, but that's all I've ever had. Saints, the prince of the torn apart. And you're the lighthouse keeper, true to the owner of a shipwrecked heart. Take heart, and if you can't take heart, take someone else's heart. Someone took my heart. They came in, now I'm torn apart. We should grade together, not that pigeon chested Trafalgar grade. The grade that greets you on that first October day, yeah. Russian front, last wolves, baby. And a skeleton of life, the love kills. Cause you're the queen of sadness, the princess of the house of pain. To the holder of the flickering flame. If
usually, we never realise which songs are the best ones until we play them to other people. Do we?
Yeah.
It's like, well, it's, as soon as you play it to other people and you see their face, the reaction, you know instantly which are the right ones. That's the acid test, isn't it, really? Mm-hmm. Play it to our friends and stuff.
Mm-hmm. Never really seems to take a step where we say, oh, we want this to sound like as though it's going to get in the charts.
Mm.
In fact, our rehearsal room, which is where we get the stuff together after we've written it, it's got quite a grubby feel to it. You know, smelly carpets and more like you'd have for a rock band than a sort of commercial pop band.
Nobody who's in a band really plays for money, I don't think. Because all those years and years of being in bands for people like me, you never got anything out of it, but still did it. So it's certainly not for money. You never think about the money when you do it. I think if you did, you'd make pretty awful records. But if somebody said to you, would you rather have a number one or a number 10, all other things being equal, I'd rather have number one. but we're not going to go and kill ourselves in order to get number one instead of number 10.
Perfect 10, but she wears a 12. Baby, keep a little 2 for me. She could be sweet 16, busting out of the seams. It's still love in the first degree.
When he's at my game, with a big fat A, you want to see the smile on my face. And even at my door, with a poor, 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 there ain't no man can replace. Sweet love, I love in different sizes. I love her body, especially the lies. Time takes its toll, but not on the eyes. Promise me this, take me tonight. If it's extra life,
that's me.
Well, I'm in charge. I can word this thing on time. And if it's XXL, well, what the hell? Every penny don't fit the slot.
Yeah, anorexic chicks, the model six, they don't hold no weight with me. Well, 8 out of 9. Well, that's just fine, but I like to hold something I can see.
Sweet love, I love in different sizes. I love her body, especially the lies. Time takes its toll, but not on the eyes. Promise me this, take me tonight.
I bought a watch to time your beauty. And I've had a pair of second hands.
I bought a candle, and every month is taken up by love. Sweet love, I love in different sizes. I love her body, especially the lies. Time takes a toll, but not on the eyes. Promise me this, take me tonight. Different sizes, I love her body, especially the lies. Time takes its toll, but not on the eyes. Promise me this, take me tonight. Weekend
from Los Angeles, one of music's biggest events, my VH1 Music Awards. But don't just watch, get involved.
Cool,
you can vote for the best UK acts on our website at www.vh1.co.uk. No recounts, no lawyers, it's up to you. Then watch the main event on my VH1 Music Awards weekend, this weekend.
Karen, honey,
when are you going to settle down?
Look at your sister, she's married with 3 lovely kids.
Look at me, I've had 2 perfect marriages.
Stevens, can you help me? It's about the Kisaki deal.
Yeah, about your motor, love. We had a bit of trouble with the clutch, and your carburetor's going to cost you a few bucks.
And your brakes are open evil up.
I'm just borrowing your dress. I promise I won't stain it again.
Karen, please. I know you need to spike, but please, can't we talk about it, darling?
Thanks, Bobby. Merry Christmas.
Because we can rely on Amazon.co.uk to deliver our Christmas presents, we can sit back and take it nice and easy.
Snowy white smile.
Christmas stocking. Make yourself comfy, my wee laddie.
Amazon.co.uk, a real company in a virtual world.
December the 2nd on Sky Digital Channel 199. Another UK home is burgled. And worst of all, one in three burglaries happen when people are at home. Don't wait until this happens to you. Call ADT now. We're the UK's number one in providing home security systems. With ADT monitoring, your system is linked to our alarm receiving centre, where trained professionals watch over your family and home 24 hours a day. Alarm signals are carefully monitored. And where appropriate, we will call the police or fire brigade. Call 0800 1698 999 and you can have an ADT system installed in your home from as little as £299. And equivalent to less than a pound a day for monitoring and service. For a limited time, we'll add a monitored fire detector to your system for free. So call ADT now on 0800 1698 999. Your whole family will sleep a little easier.
That's what we're here for.
ADT monitoring, the alarm that will never be ignored.
Taking you inside music.
Never imagine that you actually have feelings.
VH1. Your music. Your moments.
Happened overnight.
The tears I knew I'd cry, all unnoticed.
just down below. I'm where the Tongue Bell Farm Quicksilver